So, marketing departments are changing, and the only person that can change them is you. If you're prepared to accept the challenge that I'm kind of throwing at you tonight, you have the opportunity to take a stronger, mission-critical role within a company. And I use that phrase on purpose, because it's absolutely critical to the success of your business that you get digital into your DNA, because it is a fundamental shift in how business is structured and created and sold and serviced, and you need to go there. And you'll see also an expansion in your own marketing teams, because you have to bring people in to actually be able to do this. The days of throwing it at an agency for 15% are over, guys. They're over.
Unfortunately, in the short term, we are forced to work with our agencies.
Absolutely.
Whether they are traditional marketing agencies or digital agencies, I increasingly find that they're clueless. They simply don't have a handle on what they're talking about. Yeah. How do I separate the chaff from the grain when it comes to agencies?
You know, it's everywhere right now. Digital is scaring the daylights out of agencies. And what they've done is they've said, oh, we do digital too. Yes, we've digital expertise. Go find somebody at digital, quick. We've loads of digital. Yes. I was at a meeting in Dublin, actually, and there was three agencies there. And they were laughing because they all used the same guy from a small digital agency when a client came in and they wanted to introduce their digital expert. Oh yeah, here's John, here's our digital expert. And one client met both agencies and walked into the room and was introduced to the same guy by two companies as he's our digital guru. We're investing a lot in digital right now. So I tell you what, I'm not trying to kill agencies. You know, agencies bring expertise and knowledge and ability that's just fantastic. I'm not trying to kill them. What I am doing is I want to beat them senseless. I really do. I get violently angry at agencies that just, A, are doing such a disservice to their clients by not really understanding digital. Your agency should be the person leading this charge, and instead you're having to drag them along, kicking them to try and get them to move somewhere, okay? You can tell a bad agency, you can tell an agency doesn't get digital a million miles away, because they still keep wanting to sell you TV, radio, and print the whole time. There's no level of integration, there's no call to action that flows across the three, there's no way of connecting things up in any way, shape, or form. There's just more big stones, lots of big stones. So just look for the big stones. There's a lot of small, creative digital agencies springing up that have grown from digital people, okay? Go find them. Because if you go to Google and you say digital agency, well, you'll see them, because they know that they need to be found. They get digital. Okay, that's the first thing. The second thing is, I'm not saying turn the world on its head tomorrow. If you do, you're gonna get fired, simple as that. Because you are trying to challenge an industry. Okay, think about that for a sec. Advertising and marketing isn't a department. This is an industry. Industries move slowly. And the only thing I'd say to you is that change has got to come from within. That change has got to come from within your organization. And the best way to do it is, as I had said earlier on, start small. Do something yourself. Take control back a little bit from an agency in a particular area. Start small, see if you can get a couple of internal people to take ownership for something, and see what the dynamic is. See, well, what are the real resourcing issues here for me? When we, you know, we train people and we survey them, 3 months afterwards, 6 months afterwards, 9 months afterwards, and we ask them, well, what are the challenges for you? And the biggest challenge is time. Time is the constant issue. It's not the technology, it's not the money, it's not the lack of budget, it's time. I don't have time to do this. Because this is about actually being more involved with your customer, changing your campaign on a regular basis, and suddenly that's not how we've worked before. That's not how we've worked. The other challenge as well is buying a TV ad or a radio ad or a print ad is a well-worn path in every company I know. Whether it's out through an agency or whether it's internal, it's a well-worn path. We've been doing it for years. And now you're actually trying to cut a brand new path, which is to actually do digital. And your agency isn't helping you, and you're going to have to kind of plow that yourself in one sense. But my word of advice is start small. Start small, get quick wins, prove something. That gives you ammunition to then take on something bigger and something bigger. And slowly but surely, you'll be able to infiltrate all the different aspects of it. But I commiserate when it comes to agencies. And we talk to agencies all the time. We train agency people all the time. But they are the ones who should be leading this charge, and they're not. They're actually not. So, and that's a global problem right now. Personnel. This is there's a global shortage in digital skills right across the world. The European Commission started a task force 2 weeks ago because they identified that by the end of 2015, there will be a 1 million person shortfall in Europe with digital skills. And they looked at our college graduates and they said, they don't have them. So they've started this massive cross-skilling and upskilling program around the EU in order to try and fill that, because they've said, this is our competitive advantage as a region walking out the door right now, unless we're prepared to actually grasp hold of this. So that's why we're running training programs, to lift the digital level of knowledge in the digital economy.